Welcome to the Utility Emergency Response Podcast, where we talk all things emergency response, disaster response, to help your utility. I'm your host, Isaac Alatorre from Portable Pipeline Systems, leaders in the Layflat hose system industry. We have guest speakers who are experts in their field to help you and your utility get on the right foot. Let's get started with the episode. In the public water, wastewater, and flood management industry. We're here with another episode of Portable Pipeline Systems podcast, and we're here to talk about supply chain issues in this business. Now, supply chain issues have been an issue for everybody recently, but I came across a really good article, which I'm going to kind of summarize for you and then talk about how this applies to not only, in the case of this article, chemical shortages within the water business, but also layflat hose and how it could place to layflat hose and doing, you know, getting the hose and be able to bypass during an emergency. And not just my equipment, layflat hose, but other stuff as well. This is really relevant to everybody right now. So if you want to look at this article, it's in the OpsFlow magazine, pardon me, and it's titled Learning from Past Supply Chain Challenges. So it's this month's April 2022, OpsFlow magazine of the American Water Works Association. So really great article for anybody who wants to learn, hey, what's going on with this supply chain issues, because it has affected water plants, the water distribution business as well. And what really stood out to me at this article was that even basic, you know, chemicals that water treatment plants needed were lack in supply. They having a tough time getting it. And some of the chemicals were chlorine. Chlorine was difficult to get. We're talking as early as, you know, February of 2021. Sodium hydroxide was hard to get. Calcium hypochlorite, if I hope I'm saying that right. Calcium hypochlorite, that was also tough to get. So the article goes into what do they do to, you know, to make sure, you know, we get the priority. Because you think about it, water treatment plants, wastewater treatment plants, they do need the priority, because that's a basic critical infrastructure need, not only for, you know, for us to drink, but also for industry as well. So it also talked about the availability of carbon dioxide, which is also a huge issue for water companies. And they had some really good points here, basically talking about how the EPA got involved and, you know, different Homeland Security agencies, and how they communicated the, you know, they try to address the issues of why everything was slowing down with the private industry. So EPA tried to identify some root causes and the supply disruption in a real, you know, timely manner. EPA, tried to get ahead of this. I thought they did a really good job. They even got involved with the Federal Railroad Administration and the American Railroads Association of American Railroads to make sure that chlorine were prioritized for water companies and their, you know, and their customers. So really, really, really good stuff here. And also, another thing was interesting was that they had some really good ideas, which I think applies to, you know, chemicals, layflat hose, anything, generators, you know, anything that you need during an emergency response situation. What they did here is they had a couple suggestions. Number one, which I think is huge, a mutual aid and assistance network, such as the Water and Wastewater Agency Response Network, other known as WARN. So if you're Cal WARN, you're Texas WARN, whatever, Colorado WARN, whatever WARN that you have, you know, get involved. I would highly suggest you get involved, your utility involved. Not only just for equipment, but also personnel. You can if there's, you know, something goes wrong, you can count on these people to provide you people, some boots on the ground. So, they also suggest here that Warren has adopted a broader preparedness mission by working with state agencies as well and water sector associations like, you know, the American Water Works Association. Another thing I think that tends to be overlooked is creating interdependencies and partnerships with the private industry. They had a great point in here that if a utility is, like, let's say it's running out of CO2, the utility can consider working with a nearby packing facility that depends on water services to operate, and in turn the packing facility can give a deal to provide CO2 during a shortage. Or let's say you can go to your neighboring water utility and say, hey, we're out of this A, B, and C, and D. We're going to try to, you know, let's do a trade. Because during an emergency or during even just if you're running low on shortage, it's a great way to fall back on something and have someone else to help you out. And that's why mutual aid agreements are so important. So I try to emphasize this a lot to my customers when it comes to Layflat hose. Let's say you buy a trailer, or you buy, you know, let's say you buy a bunch of 1-inch, a bunch of 2-inch NSF hose, or 1- and 2-inch wastewater hose. Maybe your larger utility buys a bigger system, and you diversify by getting the lower end sizes. And then when an emergency comes, you guys can help each other out. So something to consider, just because it's pretty difficult out there right now. And when you guys all help each other, the community is what is going to get you through an emergency or a disaster. So great suggestions in this article. So look up some takeaways. If you had to take away anything from this podcast, I would take up two major things. Sign up for Warn. Sign up for your Cal Warn, Texas Warn, whatever. Work with local and county emergency management agencies to get involved, to cross-sector training and exercise opportunities. That's always super essential. The second, get involved with private industry as well. Like even if it involves masks or, you know, generators, make sure you have a contract, working contract with them, and to prioritize you when there's an emergency. Because let's face it, water, wastewater are essential needs. So I would talk to your vendors and say, what can we do to, you know, be priority if something happens? Do we get prioritized inventory? Okay, so just my two cents on this. I think you can do the same with Layflat hose, trailers. You can, you know, special fittings and all that stuff it does matter in the long run. So, you know, just try to do this ahead of time. That way you're not running like crazy trying to figure out what to do when the emergency actually comes. All right. So anyways, I wanted to make this podcast very short. You know, nothing long. Just wanted to give you a couple points that kind of make you understand what we're going through with the supply chain issues. My customers are pretty impatient. They want their stuff, equipment now, but just everything is so delayed right now. It's a really tough time for vendors and for customers. It's no fun. So hopefully we get out of this soon. I don't think it's gonna go away anytime soon. It's gonna be like this, I think, for the next 1 or 2 years. I'm hoping maybe it ends faster, but according to all the articles I've been reading, it just seems like the industry side, you know, they just can't find enough workers. You got COVID, and then plus you put just one disaster can throw everything off even more. So just keep that in mind and try to prepare as much ahead, think ahead, and you'll be better off in the long run. Okay, so great to, if you're listening, I really appreciate it. And you reach out to me if you have anything else you want to talk about, or if you'd like me to talk to you about on this podcast, or even on a video, one of my videos on YouTube. You know, please subscribe to my YouTube. I'm also very active on LinkedIn. I'm very active on Facebook. You know, feel free to reach out to me on any of those channels. Okay. Or email me or even call me. I'm not afraid of a call as well. All right. So thanks, guys. Hope you're staying safe out there. And again, like I said, always think ahead. Well, responders, you made it to the end. I wanted to thank you for listening to this show. Please do me a solid and share this with one of your friends or coworkers in the utility industry so they can get benefit from such great information. Subscribe to this podcast. Follow us on social media. Also, our email newsletter, which these episodes go directly to your inbox. Thank you for your time, and remember, be safe and think ahead.